Hello again from the American Diabetes Association's 75th Scientific Sessions, the largest diabetes meeting in the world. I'm Rhonda Anderson with another breaking news update from the Boston Convention and Exhibition Center. Today we uncovered new research on how one class of diabetes medications alters the brain's response to food, possibly reducing cravings and increasing satisfaction while eating. This particular group of diabetes drugs called GLP-1 receptor agonists is derived from gut hormones. These have also been shown to reduce body weight, and researchers have been trying to understand how. When you eat, several hormones are released, sending information to the central nervous system to regulate your appetite. GLP-1 is one of them, giving you a sense of fullness. Previous studies have shown that the brains of obese people have a greater response to pictures of food than those of lean people. Their brains also have a reduced reward response during the consumption of food, which may lead to overeating. So researchers in Amsterdam tested the hypothesis that exenatides, a medication that mimics the effect of that GLP-1 hormone found naturally in the body, was helping patients with type 2 diabetes lose weight by altering the brain's response to food consumption and decreasing appetite. Using functional MRIs, which measure brain activity by detecting changes in blood flow, they looked at the reward centers in the brains of obese people with and without type 2 diabetes. They measured the response to the anticipation of and drinking of chocolate milk while being given GLP-1 receptor agonist intravenously versus a placebo. The scientists found that the medication decreased anticipatory food reward, which may reduce cravings, and increase the feeling of food reward during consumption, which may reduce overeating. Further study is needed to learn about the mechanisms by which these reward centers are activated. And other hormones may come into play here. With obesity on the rise, fueling an epidemic of type 2 diabetes, these will certainly be important areas of study. There is also one side note about this study. The researchers are also interested in determining if GLP-1 receptor agonists can alter cravings for drugs, alcohol, and nicotine in humans, offering a possible treatment for substance abuse. To view this press release online, visit the newsroom section of our website, diabetes.org. I'll be back soon with more of the latest news and research from the American Diabetes Association's 75th Scientific Sessions. Be sure to stay tuned to diabetes.org/breaking news, and on our social media channels, use hashtag 2015ADA. I'm Rhonda Anderson in Boston.